I was here before independence. Lots have changed in the meantime, but lots stayed the same. Luanda, capital of Angola. 6 million people, extreme wealth for a few, prosperity for a few more, but poverty for the majority. The revolution in Angola became a gruesome civil war that lasted until 2002. Dr. Antonio Agostinho Neto became Angola's first president in 1975. He died in 1979.
500 years ago, the Portuguese arrived in our country and they are exploiting our people and oppressing.
The Portuguese colonial power did not accept a peaceful transition to independence. The liberation movements had no choice but to fight for their freedom. In the end, the MPLA won the battle. NATO's legacy is still the inspiration to achieve a better future for all the people of Angola, for those who suffered under Portuguese colonialism, fought for the liberation of their country, as well as for the young generation, men and women alike, who want to build a just society based on the principles of the MPLA. General education for everyone is a main target for the government and for a number of international organizations working in Angola. Successful private initiative like here, in a former soap factory, in one of the poor neighborhoods of Luanda, attracts lots of children. For some theories, the scrap heap seems to be the final destination. Even Karl Marx becomes a victim of time. Times have changed. Modern techniques dictate the daily life of ordinary people, men and women alike. Pilgrimage to Black Rocks in the middle of Angola has the purpose to worship and pray for the future. 500 years ago, a queen of a powerful tribe left her footprint here on the Black Rocks. This is a historic sign for better times to come. We leave this message for the coming generation. You are on the road to prosperity.